pleasure to see you, Sugar Ray. This is the 12th time you're doing this. What makes it sweeter year after year to put together this event and fight for the cause that you are?
I just feel that we're getting closer and closer to a way, a means of knocking out diabetes. My father, my friends, I mean, I've seen so many special people of mine, friends, family, suffer. But you know what? As I was in the rain for 50 years, I am so optimistic, I'm so confident that we will knock out diabetes.
And you use this event to support that. Why is that important for you to put together this annual event to bring everyone together and fight for the cause together?
Because it costs. I mean, and also, it's got to come together as a people, as one. I learned the hard way, but I learned very fast that you need a corner in life. Not only in the ring, but you need a corner in life.
And for everyone wondering what Sugar Ray is up to these days when he's not putting together events like this, not being at the ringside for all the big-time fights, how would you describe your day-to-day and what you're up to these days in your retirement?
Well, I wake up pretty early because I'm so used to waking up. Like back in the day, it was 5:30 in the morning. I wake up. I still wake up 5:30 to 6. And I try to be productive. I work out. I work out almost like every day, three, 4 days a week, and just stay healthy. And that's why I'm here. Mm-hmm. How often do you work out?
I try to work out every day if I could, but sometimes life gets in the way.
Yeah, okay. I'll give you that.
Ray, one question. You've always looked at Crawford Spence Crawford. Now that it may happen, what are your thoughts now that it finally is happening? And has it sort of frustrated you seeing so much time taken to like make the fight happen? Because you have network deals, different promoters. What are your thoughts now that the fight may actually happen July 29th?
I want to see it. I will be there. I just accept what it is. Backing out my time, my era. You fought the champion. To say I'm champion, the best, prove it by fighting the best. You know, these guys, I love all these guys. And that's why sometimes it's hard for me to select one over the other. Let's put it this way. If Muhammad Ali, someone asked Muhammad Ali, could Ray beat Hagler? And if he said no, it would have hurt me so bad. So I don't do that. You understand what I'm saying? Yeah. But the best man will win. One thing I know about that is winning. No matter how low you are, or how many rounds you've won, there's always a chance to come back.
Well said. Okay? I'll say one thing. You remember my dad's favorite fighters. And even though he passed away, I know that my dad enjoyed you. You gave him great joy. You're a good man. I appreciate just who you are in and out of the ring.
How did your father pass?
2018. Yeah. Almost 90 years old.
My father was 95 when he passed away.
Yeah. Good genes. Yeah. All the best to you, Ray.
Thanks, man. Thanks.
Can I get your...
What's that?
Come on, if I get your autograph.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thanks so much. Happy birthday, by the way.
Well, thanks, man.
I had to play the softballs anyway, so you got the good question.
That I'm part of the awareness. This is
what up, Valley? What up,
man? Hey, who won, Loma or Haney?
I said it on my Twitter. I said it was a great fight. A draw would have been great. It was either Loma or a draw. I just, Haney fought a great fight, especially early in the fight. But Loma did his thing, and it was a story. You know, it's kind of like I'm comparing it to Hagler versus Leonard. You know, a lot of people thought that Hagler won. If you look at it round by round, okay, maybe you could give it to Hagler. But who stole the story? Who was retired for so long? Who was supposed to get knocked out? Who was in his 30s? That was sure Ray Leonard. So it's building a story. It's capturing hearts. And the judges aren't, they're susceptible too. The fans, the judges. So Loma, I think, stole the night with something that he shouldn't have done, just like Ray did. You know,
well, ironically, they robbed him, so he didn't steal it. But let me ask you this. Spence and Crawford, break it down. You know Spence, you know Crawford?
Yeah, listen, man, I'm glad that the fight finally got announced. You know, I would have to say Spence because he's slightly bigger. But, you know, Bud Crawford's just mean, man. Both these fighters are mean. Whoever hurts each other first to the body, it's going to be to the body. I mean, up top, I don't see Spence or Bud Crawford penetrating that defense. I think someone's going to get hurt to the body. Spence is an excellent body puncher. I mean, it's a toss-up. It's a toss-up, man.
When you're going to be in India on Saturday, I mean, I know Alexis Bocha and Anthony Young, but the fight of the night may be Oscar Collazo and Melvin Druce. Thoughts on that fight?
Oscar
Collazo and Melvin Druce, 105-pound title.
I haven't studied that fight yet.
Ellie Seckback, reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.